today we are just outside of Turweston near Brackley in West Northamptonshire, and we're standing on top of what will be the UK's largest green overbridge. We're currently halfway through lifting the beams onto the bridge. In total, there'll be 34 beams on this structure. We're lifting these beams in pairs, so in total there'll be 17 pairs lifted into place, making up the total of 34 beams. Currently we've lifted 6 pairs of beams into place and we're approaching the halfway mark of the beam lifts.
The bridge itself is 99 meter width on a 56 meter span. So each pair of beam is around 55.5 meters long. Majority of the steel has been prefabricated and brought on site and installed with a small crane, which we can see at the end of each abutment.
On top of this significant structure, there will be a country lane and a footpath, whilst simultaneously either side of that having a biodiverse corridor to allow wildlife, insects and animals to cross the HS2 railway. This is going to be quite significant for the local communities. Whilst simultaneously connecting the local communities together, it will also integrate the railway into the local environment and mask the railway that is here.
The main thing for a green overbridge for us is really to make sure that we're not isolating species, also to ensure that we've got connectivity. There's 33 square kilometres of habitat that we need to connect on this route across HS2. And it's really vital for us as HS2 to ensure that we are protecting our ecology, protecting the environment, and also reduce road traffic accidents from that ecology going onto the road network. So we'll go from what we can see today, which is in a deep cutting, to what will be covered over. All you'll see is the top of the structure. It will be beautiful and green. It will have that connectivity element to it. And you won't see the actual train going through in this specific area. So from a visual perspective for the local constituents, you won't have an impact from the train in this area. It's pivotal for us and critical for us to ensure we've got that connectivity from an environmental and ecological perspective, and obviously from our commitment in terms of carbon reduction and our footprint on the landscape. It's imperative for us to ensure that the local species, fauna and flora, have that connectivity and are able to move from one side of the trace to the other side of the trace safely.
It's great to see the culmination of all the hard work that has undertaken over the last year or so come together, especially in this stage now we're lifting the beams into place. I'm really excited to see what this bridge is going to look like when it's completed in the near future.
It's extremely exciting. We've taken one step closer to having HS2 operational. It's imperative that HS2 is operational, freeing space on the local networks, allowing more freight to be operational, which is best from a carbon perspective. So it's twofold. There's a massive sort of excitement and real feeling of pride just from an engineering perspective in terms of the level of effort to get here. We see the beams land, but I can promise you that the hours that have gone into getting to today is significant. But from a UK PLC perspective, it's massively exciting as well. HS2 has taken one step closer to becoming an operational railway.